My name's Angel Charles, and I'm all the way from Shepherd's Bush, London, but my heritage is Grenadian. And I feel like that feeds through in my music as well, which is very, very important. Because a lot of the things that come through in my music, element-wise, is definitely from the culture, from Grenada, from the background. My name means, did you know what? To be fair, it's actually more of a metaphor to me, because I ain't that angelic, but I'm very spiritual. Music's all I know. Apart from growing up in a community where you can be drawn out and there's loads of crazy different things happening, it's easy to take the wrong path. I would say, like, God is merciful because he kept me on the music side of things. He kept me in the music lane, and I feel like no matter what was going on in the streets, I was always attached fully to the music. It's built me, it's made me who I am today, and I feel like, you know, if I didn't have music, I genuinely don't know where I'd be, but this is what I know how to do. This is what I love, and I don't feel like I could do anything else. I started making beats first on the Atari. You couldn't really record audio into that joint, and the screen was black and white, and we had to make beats out of that. So I was making beats, not being able to record vocals, just having to keep the ideas in my head. And then my dad bought me an 8-track. And then it just came mandatory to me. It came to nature in my life that this is what I love doing. And then started going on to do all the Christmas carols at school, and never turn back them days and turn back the hands of time. And none of that joke, like, for where I am right now. If I hadn't gone through any of that stuff, it might have been like, I might have been just like this guy that's just trying to step into music now, trying to figure it out. It's made me again who I am. I think it's made me so advanced. Like, that gave me such a head start knowing all those things. I never ever went to do a 9-to-5 or something like that. Or even if I could have, I didn't really. I just knew it wasn't in me. One of the collabs that I'm most proud about is the Blessings remix, my new record that I've got out now. And why I say that is not just because of it's some of our biggest artists in the world. It's because if I go back to the days that I grew up on the street corner for listening to French Montana. My friend put me onto that. Do you get what I'm saying? Listen to this new guy, boom, 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 Frenchie, boom, boom, boom. And I latched in and I was like, rah, that's sick, that's cold. Coming up now, doing my record, my biggest record of all time now, and it's like Frenchie's on. That's like such a blessing, you understand? Davido now. An ex-G in his own right, you understand? Kill the place. I listen to his stuff and it's like, rah, that man's bad. And then you never think nothing of it. You just think that's Davido, he's bad. Listen to Davido, big fan of him. Now I'm in the studio recording with him. And then my favorite singer of all time, grew up like, swear by her. I got to be in the studio of her and with her and make a track with her, and that's brand new. So that was another massive moment and proud moment for me. It just shows me like how great God is. That's one of my favorite records, you understand? If you want to talk about meeting up with people like Swiss and him being my mentor, I got people like him. I got Kalani, Rodney Jerkins. I got cold ass people that I've met along the way and built great relationships with, and still to this day, that novelty will never wear off. Because these are things I all dreamt about once upon a time, and God's making it happen for me. I think without the faith, there's no deed. You understand? It's like, it's never going to happen if you don't believe it. I feel like the energy I bring, or I try my hardest to put out into this world, is culture. Yeah, good music. Yeah, great music, shall I say. And to just shout out to my fans and tell them without them, I would definitely not be who I am. I wouldn't have the inspiration I have. I wouldn't get that motivation to write things, because as I said, if it weren't for them, or they weren't following you, or they didn't, you understand, share your stuff, and you understand, who would Angel be if I had no cult following? But I just want to put out into the world that, you know, I'm trying to just make great music that when you hear it, the instruments, the melodies, the harmonies, just do something to you. You don't even have to like me. You like that. You see that idiot Angel, that tune's hard, you know. You understand? And it's just because of, it's just the music.